All eyes on me. Let me introduce myself. Mr. Pringles, the barber, always
cut his head honcho. You know what it is.
Yes, I'm going to jump straight in. Man, what do y'all feel about this Ice Cube situation? That's been a big talk. You know, they call Ice Cube a coon. Man, they call Ice Cube all kind of names right now, man. Listen, this election is just going to divide a lot of people. I'm in a position right now, like, you know, I dropped the Trump for Dummies segment about a week ago. And I mean, you know, Trump ain't got, you know, all his marbles ain't there. I don't know. I'm going to just be honest. I don't know who to vote for at this point. And I don't want to just go with the flow of things. So right now, I'm just doing my research and checking out the policies that both parties have and what's going to be best for me. Because that's looking like, I think we're picking the less of two evils. Now, listening to what Ice Cube had to say, Ice Cube is basically saying he presented the contract for Black America to both parties. He's saying that the Republicans, you know, pushed him off, said they'll speak with him about it after the election. I mean the Democrats said they would speak with him after the election. Okay, so he went to the Republicans, and the Republicans, you know, they gave him, you know, they listened to what he had to say and then implemented some of what he had in the contract into their policy, the platinum package, supposedly. I get what he's saying, and I also understand the other side of things, too. You know, Trump has done so much against us as African Americans, you know, Black people. You know, it's hard to look at it like, how could you support this man? And then at the same time, you got to look at it from where his standpoint is. Regardless of who gets in office, I want to present this to both parties. Because if the person you want in office doesn't get in office, so what, we supposed to sit back and wait another 4 years till we get in a good position? Nah, I want to reach both parties, because it's going to take both to get something done. So I'm really not totally against what Ice Cube. I understand his logic. I feel like we definitely need to sit and do our research before we vote. This is going to be a crazy election, man. I'm hoping that this doesn't excite any riots and all that. I don't know what's about to take place. I do know that I'm going to sit down and do my research before I vote. I'm not just about to go with the floor things. You know, both of them have racist ways. I feel that. I feel like, you know, I mean, it's documented that, you know, Joe Biden in the past had, you know, a few racial situations himself. So I don't know how to go about it. I tell you what. My thing is, with all these policies and all this talk about what everybody gonna do, what's gonna happen once you elected? This is my thing. You know, I'm gonna tell you how I look at it. You know, I went there some time, and when I wouldn't take my plea to cop out to my plea, I was told that I would get out in a year. This was by mouth. This wasn't written down on paper. So this being my first time, I didn't know that's what I needed to do. I needed to get that written in, you know, get that written in ink. So I end up doing the whole 5 years instead of getting out in a year. I didn't have nothing to stand on. That was just their word. So this is the same situation. When they writing these policies, is it documented in ink, signed in ink, that when I'm in office, this is going to take place? Or is this just something that's written up just to get your votes? And that goes for both parties. And that's what I'm afraid of. Like, that's what I don't know which way to turn. I'm not just about to just go vote just because, you know, a mass body of people, like, this is what we're supposed to do. Everybody just follow suit. This is not a follow suit situation. This election is very detrimental, can be very detrimental at the end of the day if the right person doesn't get in office. Economy-wise, you know, I'm hearing that if Biden gets in office, the economy is going to be terrible. And if Trump gets in office, we're going to have a great economy. Now, I don't know which way to look at it. And I feel like you all, I mean, everybody do their research, man. Just do your research before you go vote. That's the best thing that I can say. Hey, do your research. I'm gonna go ahead and get up out of here, man. You know, I'm about to go check out some more of this Ice Cube, do some more research on what Ice Cube talking about. He got me scratching my head. I respect him and I understand. I feel where he's coming from. You need to speak with both people. Yeah, so I mean, y'all have a nice night. Signing off, it's your boy, Mr. Pringles the Barber, a.k.a. Always Cutting's Head Honcho.
It's been great, my fellow constituents. I appreciate you all tuning in to Always Cutting Barber Talk. Ladies and gents, have a great night.
You know what it is.